Now, we will discuss another application of Ampere circuit law. So far, we know about Ampere circuit law, and by using that Ampere circuit law, we have derived the field, the magnetic field in a current carrying circular wire inside, outside, and on the surface of the cylindrical wire. Now the next application of that Ampere circuit law, by using that Ampere circuit law, we'll calculate the magnetic field due to a current carrying solenoid. We will calculate or derive the magnetic field due to a current carrying solenoid. Now, there is a question arises in your mind, what is a solenoid? What do you mean by a solenoid? The simple way that solenoid is that any ferromagnetic material that is called as the core, C-O-R-E, core. Any ferromagnetic material is there, a rod, a cylindrical rod of ferromagnetic material on which tightly wound, insulated wire. Take the wires which are insulated, the wires are, the surface is insulated. And take the wire and we will wound that on the core or the material. So the tightly wounded wires, and sometimes there is no material, only the space is air. Means take the wires, insulated wires, and wound tightly. They wound tightly, and that the diameter of the coil, when you wound that, it will give you a coil form. The diameter of the coil is smaller than the length. Smaller than the length. Then that is called as a solenoid. That is called as a solenoid. So let me write what is a solenoid first. A cylindrical coil of many tightly wound, many tightly wounded tongues, of insulated wire with diameter of the coil smaller than the length is called a solenoid. Is called as a solenoid. A cylindrical coil of many tightly wounded tongues of insulated wire with diameter of the coil smaller than the length is called as a solenoid. And inside, in the core, inside the solenoid, you can take mostly ferromagnetic materials, iron, is inserted to increase the magnetic field that we will discuss in this topic. In this derivation, we will discuss why you will like. So, you can take by taking some material inside the core of the solenoid or without any material. First, we will discuss without the material, only air medium is there or free space. Then we will discuss when I insert a ferromagnetic material like iron, then what happens? Is the magnetic field increases or no? That we will discuss. But this is a solenoid. So a solenoid, you can say, is a form that is called, you can say that it is in the form of helix. In the form of helix. The wires are in the form of helix. Right? So I can write this as also a solenoid has wire wounded, has wire one wounded in the form of helix. In the form of helix. So if I show that, now you show in a figure wire, they are wounded like this and they are tightly wounded like this. They are tightly, closely packed like that. This is one turn, another turn, another turn, another turn like that. This is the form of helix. So I will show that again more clearly. Let me draw that more clearly. The current enters and the current will come up. And the current flows like this. When it enters like this, then goes like, then comes like this. In this way, the current flows. And remember one thing, a current carrying solenoid is equivalent to a bar magnet. A current carrying solenoid is equivalent to a bar magnet. A current carrying solenoid. A current carrying solenoid is equivalent to a bar magnet. Like in your bar magnet, when you draw the magnetic field lines around a bar magnet, what the nature, what the curve you are getting, the same thing you will get in this solenoid form. And if you calculate also for a bar magnet, already you know for a bar magnet that magnetic field at any point on the axial line, already you have derived. On that basis, if you calculate the magnetic field on the axis of the solenoid, on this axis of the solenoid, you will get the same result. So on that basis, a current carrying solenoid is equivalent to a bar magnet. If I show that, this, how this can be, if you show the magnetic field for, so this is about the solenoid. If you show this one, let me erase this part. So if you show this, as you know, for a bar magnet, sometimes take a bar magnet like this. For a bar magnet, there is a south pole and there is a north pole. The magnetic field line starts from the north pole outside and enters to the south pole, and inside, this is from south to north. This already you know and already you have read this one. Clear? And if you show on this side also, from north to south and inside from south to north, south to north, and outside it is from north to south, north to south. This is the magnetic field lines due to a bar magnet. Same procedure if you show this one. In this case, if you show this one, here also it shows like that. So this is south side and this is north side. Inside the core of the solenoid, the magnetic field lines are very strong from south to north. These are very strong from south to north. Inside, this is from south to north and outside from north to south, and from outside it is from north to south. It is from north to south like this. North enters to south. Again, also this is the north to south, and it is like this. North enters towards south. These are the lines. And here also in this region also you can show that. This also in this region. With these cones also you can show that. North to south, north to south. So these are the fields north south, north to south. So this is the magnetic field lines. These are the magnetic field lines or the magnetic field around the solenoid. And this is equivalent like a bar magnet. This is equivalent like a, this is equivalent a, equivalent to a bar magnet. So let me draw this. Is you can draw that by your own. Not so. So this is the point, that this is the magnetic field around the sun. And by this you can show that this is very important thing, with that inside the solenoid, this is the inside the solenoid, the magnetic field is uniform, and the magnetic field is uniform and very strong. Outside the solenoid, the magnetic field is weak, very weak, and non-uniform. And for an ideal solenoid means in which the wires are wound very tightly, closely packed. The wires are very closely packed. There is no space. That is called as an ideal solenoid. In case of an ideal solenoid, we will consider the magnetic field outside the solenoid is zero. The magnetic field outside the solenoid is zero because they are non-uniform and very weak. So we can consider that practically they are zero. But inside they are not zero. B is not equal to zero inside. B is not equal to zero inside. Okay, so let me write also this one also. Let me write here. Solenoid. The magnetic field inside, this is most important, inside the solenoid. The magnetic field inside the solenoid is uniform and very strong. Clear? However, the magnetic field, this one point, and then is the magnetic field outside the solenoid, the magnetic field outside the solenoid is non-uniform and very weak. Non-uniform and very weak. Okay. Or we can write, for an ideal solenoid. So what is an ideal solenoid? Let me write. Solenoid in which tones are tightly packed. Solenoid in which the wires are very tightly packed, and and that's very tightly packed, and their number is very large, and the number of tons is very large. For an ideal solenoid, that is an ideal solenoid, the magnetic field outside, the solenoid is zero. We can consider practically this is a zero. That is the important thing. So we know about a solenoid. What is a solenoid? The idea about a solenoid. Then how they are, the solenoids, how the magnetic fields are there inside the solenoid, and it is equivalent to a bar magnet. Then outside the solenoid, practically you can consider the magnetic field is zero. So the point is that when you calculate the magnetic field due to a current carrying solenoid, the only is that we will calculate the magnetic field at a point inside the solenoid. Right? And we are considering this is an ideal solenoid. An ideal solenoid means in which the turns are, very tightly, they are not like this, they are very tightly packed, and the number of turns very long, and the number of turns is very large. If they are tightly packed, they are very close, then the number of turns also obviously increases. So this is the case. Clear? So this is about the solenoid. Now let me calculate the magnetic field due to a current carrying solenoid. Right? Then we will calculate the magnetic field due to a current carrying solenoid. So before we calculate this one, what we will consider here is that the magnetic field due to a current carrying solenoid means, here what we will consider, a solenoid consists of number of circular rings. We can say that a solenoid is practically is a number of circular coils. One turn, another turn, another turn, another turn, like that. This is one turn, next another turn, third turn, fourth turn, like that. These are the number of turns. So each one is a one coil. So if you want to calculate the magnetic field due to the solenoid, current carrying solenoid, at a point inside, then we can say that first to calculate the magnetic field due to one turn, then add the magnetic field due to the n number of turns, or what are the number of turns in the solenoid, we will add that, and that addition should be vector sum, because obviously magnetic field is a vector quantity, the strength of magnetic field is a vector quantity, so we will take the vector sum of the magnetic field. Okay, so we will consider like that. So what we can say that, so each turn of the solenoid, is considered as a circular coil. Each turn of the solenoid is considered as a circular coil. Total magnetic field due to the solenoid is equal to the vector sum of magnetic fields due to each turn vector sum of the magnetic field of the each turn. Clear? So this is my point. So this is the, in this way you can calculate. Clear? Now this is the magnetic, now we calculate the magnetic field due to a solenoid. Now let us consider a solenoid. So as you know, already I have shown the figure of a solenoid. Let us consider these are the tightly wounded solenoid. The current enters like this, and the current is coming out, and through this coil it enters here, comes out like this. Then here enters, comes out, then it will come out like this. There is a solenoid. And you know the magnetic field, how the magnetic field is there. Now with this solenoid, now think that this solenoid Let the solenoid consist of n number of turns. N is the total number of turns of the solenoid of length L. Let L be the total number of turns of the solenoid of length L. Then what is the number of turns per unit length? Let me take that is small l. Then N is equal to N by L. If the length is L, total number of turns of the solenoid of length L, then N is equal to N by L means this is called as the number of turns per unit length. Is that clear? So small n is the number of turns per unit length of the what? Of the solenoid. Small n is the number of turns per unit length of the solenoid. Right? So now you think that this is a solenoid. So this is a solenoid. This is a solenoid tightly wound like that. So in this space there is no material is there, only vacuum, or you can say that is free space or air medium. And its permeability is mu naught. In this region the permeability is naught because there is no material. According to any material is there, its permeability is changes to mu, that material permeability. But there is no material, so its permeability is mu naught. Now think that, let us cut this solenoid like this. To calculate the magnetic field, let me consider, I will cut that like this. Take the solenoid like this. So what it will show you? How it will looks like? If you cut like this, this is a very important thing. When you cut like this, in this portion if you cut like this, this is the solenoid. This is the solenoid. Now I will cut like what? I will cut like this. In this way. Then here the wires are entering, here the wires are coming, then turns, but this portion is not there. I am taking only this portion, so I will show this one as this is the solenoid and these are the wires passing like this. It looks like this. These are the wires passing through the solenoid at different points. And they are very tight wound, so we can show like that. These rounds are very close and this is the cross section of the solenoid. Here, let me find the magnetic field take at a point P. P be a point. P be a point. And inside the solenoid, let the magnetic field is B. It is uniform. Inside it is uniform and very strong. Let the magnetic field is B in this direction. In the solenoid, inside the solenoid, the magnetic field is uniform. Everywhere the magnetic field is uniform, we will consider. And it is very strong. Let us take a point P where we want to calculate the magnetic field due to the current carrying solenoid. And the current is entering like this. The current is flowing in the solenoid. And this is the section of the solenoid. Now what we will do? By considering the point P, now go to your first application there also. Then you take the point. By considering the point P, let us assume a Ampérian loop. Let us assume an Ampérian loop so that the point P is on the loop. And here I will assume that the loop, let us consider the loop is like a square type, square loop. This is the Ampérian loop. Let us consider this is a Ampérian loop. Right? With P as a point. Now I will say like I write. Let E be a point. Let P be a point. Let P be a point. Let P be a point inside within the solenoid. Within the solenoid. Consider a loop like a rectangular loop also you can say, or consider a rectangular loop with, consider a rectangular loop, let me give a name to the rectangular loop, A, B, सी डी. कंसीडर ए रेक्टेंगुलर लूप ए बी सी डी. कंसीडर ए रेक्टेंगुलर लूप ए बी सी डी विथ पी ऑन द लूप विथ पी ऑन द लूप. लेट पी बी ए पॉइंट विथ कंसीडर ए रेक्टेंगुलर लूप ए बी सी डी विथ पी ऑन द लूप. दिस रेक्टेंगुलर लूप ए बी सी डी इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द एम्पिरियन लूप. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द एम्पिरियन लूप. क्लियर? So this is the assumption. Now next is the, before I use that, then according to Ampere's law, the line integral of magnetic field around the loop, the line integral of magnetic field around the loop equal to mu naught times the net current enclosed by the loop. This is the net current enclosed by the loop. With these wires, they carry current in this loop. These are the wires, enters the current, takes the current. So this is the net current enclosed by this loop. And the line integral over this rectangular loop ABCD. Right? So now let me find. Okay? So next I will write here. According to Ampere's circuit law, the line integral of magnetic field B dot dl over the which loop ABCD, let me write here ABCD closed loop, is equal to mu naught times, let the net current is I. And dl is what? A small element from the loop. On this this portion dl. Now I can make this, I can write this, the line integral of a b dot dl equal to mu naught I. So here I is the net current enclosed by the loop a b c d. Is it clear? I is the net current enclosed by the loop a b c d. Right? Now, I will find this net current enclosed by loop ABCD next stage. Next, I can write this, go for the LHS side. This can be written as, first I take the integration on this line, plus this side. Can you take? That is the bypass, making the integration into bypass. So now make the integration like that. I can write this as, first A to B, first is the A to B, B dot dl 1 plus B to C, B dot dl plus, then I can write, sorry. So we cannot put the, here we cannot put the closed one because we are making it bypass. So it is not a closed, AB is not closed. So we can write simply AB, then BC plus CD, then B dot dl plus dl, B dot dl is equal to mu naught I. The net current enclosed by the loop A, B, C. Now go for each one. So see here, this is the magnetic field. Now consider a small element dl on the path AB. DL and B both are in the same direction in this path. Now we consider a portion DL on this BC, on this length. Let us consider a small path DL. What is the direction of DL? It is a tangential DL. So what is the angle between B and DL? B is like this, DL perpendicular. Then on this side, what is the magnetic field outside the solenoid? Zero. Outside the solenoid, B is zero. So outside it is zero. Here again, if you consider a small element DL like this, B and DL. If you consider a small element DL, Then B and DL are what? Again perpendicular. B is like this, DL. They are perpendicular. Clear? So you can say this portion has no magnetic field, here is no magnetic field. Not a, I will not consider this portion also. If you consider this portion only, it is zero. Here is zero. This is already zero, this is already zero because they are outside. There is no magnetic field outside the solenoid for an ideal. So what we can write here? Or let me write here. B is perpendicular. B is perpendicular to the path. B is perpendicular to the path BC and BA. BC and BA. That is the angle between. That is angle between B and BL. Is 90. First part for BC and BA. Then the for an ideal dipole, listen, for an ideal solenoid, B is zero outside the solenoid. B is zero outside the solenoid. Now you put this in this expression. So what you will get here? This is perpendicular, so let me write again. Now let me read this person also. So this is A, B. What is the angle between here? B and DL. Zero. So I can write BDL cos zero. BDL cos 0 for BC 90, so plus B to C BDL cos 90 plus C to D, C to D outside 0 plus 0 DL, that is for C to D plus this is 0 plus DA. Along the path perpendicular B BL, sorry, B BL, it is from B to A, B BL cos 90 is equal to mu naught I. Cos 90 0 0, this is 0, cos 90 0, so the rest is only A to D. So now I can write this is A to B. So the final is that A to B BDL is equal to mu naught I. Mu naught I. I is the net current enclosed by the loop ABCD. Now, what is the net current enclosed by the loop? Now we find out. So now from here, B is uniform. So you can take outside uniform. So B, A to B, BL. Let this portion is L. Total length is L. Let us consider this is the L portion. So BL, mu naught. Now I can write I. What is this I? I is the number of terms in the loop. I can write number of terms. So let me write net current enclosed by the loop. I can write this as what is the net current enclosed by the I? Net current enclosed by the loop. If N is the number of terms per unit length, then in this whole length L, this length, let me consider this length is L, as I have taken this length is L. Suppose this length is L, if L is the number of terms per unit length, then what is the terms in this length? Number of terms per unit length, that is N is equal to N by L, number of terms per unit length. And the current is I, so I can write this is equal to N into I. That is the I. The current enclosed by the portion A, B, C, D. So you can write this as N I dash suppose also. Or N I you can say. So make this as I dash. In the previous one you can make this as I dash. I dash is the current enclosed by the loop A, B, C, D. So on that basis you can write here also. That I can write. So suppose this is equal to mu naught N I. Number of terms for unit length into I. Right? So this is equal to mu naught N I. Then what is the total length? N I L, that is your I dash, number of terms for unit length in the length L, that is equal to N into I. Clear? Then this is equal to, I can write B, what is the length AB? That is L, integration of BL is equal to L, that is equal to mu naught N I L. Remember this is I dash. In the beginning I have taken, consider this as I dash, so that this is not no confusion. This is the number of terms, so you can N is equal to number of terms. So what is the number of terms? So small N is equal to number of terms per unit length, yes or no? Then in this portion, let these are n number of terms. So what is the total length? So the number of terms n into L. And the current is I. What is the current? I into each term. So that is n into L into I, n I L. Right? So then BL is equal to mu naught n I L. So that integration of BL is L, and that AB length is, you have taken L, this AB length is L. So this is L, L get cancelled. So B is equal to mu naught N I. This is the magnetic field at a point inside the solenoid. Clear? So this is the magnetic field at a point inside the solenoid. Remember, this is a very, very important formula, where N is the number of turns per unit length. So if you put that, or you can write this in terms of your capital N, then I can write this is equal to, then I can write this is equal to H N is equal to N by L, then total number of turns in the length L. So then B is equal to mu naught N I by L. Mu naught N I by L. This is also the same formula. Here L is capital in the number of terms in the length L. It is the number of terms per unit length. So we derive the two relations. B is equal to mu naught N I the current in the solenoid, and capital N small n, already you know that. Clear? So this is the expression. Now come to the next point. As I have already told that in the solenoid, the magnetic field of the solenoid can be increased by inserting a ferromagnetic material whose relative permeability, ferromagnetic material already you read, its relative permeability or permeability is greater than, very, very greater than 1. Means, let me write. Magnetic field inside the solenoid. Magnetic field inside the solenoid can be increased by inserting a ferromagnetic material like iron of permeability mu. For any material its permeability is mu, so of permeability mu, or permeability mu. How? Go to this expression. So H or this for free space
B is equal to mu naught. Sorry, this is not capital N, this small. This is capital N, this is small n. Mu naught Ni. So B is equal to mu naught, number of terms per unit length. This is the number of terms for in the length L. Number of terms per unit length. Mu naught for free space, B is equal to mu naught. Let me take this one also, Ni. For a material inserted, for a material inserted, then B is equal to what? Mu N I, its permeability, that is mu, you have taken mu. Then if you solve this one, if you show that, what is the formula for relative permeability? What is the formula for relative permeability? Mu R is equal to mu by mu naught, permeability of the medium, permeability of free space. So mu is equal to mu naught into mu R. Now put here, so for a material, let me take this B dash is equal to mu and I. Then I can write B dash equal to, what is mu? That is equal to mu naught mu R and I. As mu R is greater than 1 for ferro, for any material is greater than 1 for ferro. So for ferro, for ferromagnetic mu R very very greater than 1, then B dash is greater than B. But you have written magnetic field inside the solenoid can be increased by inserting a ferromagnetic material like iron of permeability mu. That is the proof we have proved this one. Then again, if I will take in the same case, if I will take the point P where inside the solenoid, if the point P is just at the edge of the solenoid, this is the end, this is the solenoid length, and if the point P is here, the point P ends at this point, then in that case, if the point P comes here to the one end of the solenoid, point P comes to one end of the solenoid, then what will be the magnetic field? Get an idea? Get the idea? What the? Imagine, if the point P is there, then in this portion you have taken this length, but when it is here, outside, there is nothing. Only this portion, so it takes only half of this one. Means what is the magnetic field? Because you will take only this magnetic field. Here this is the magnetic field, but here this portion, here is the end point. So now it is only half of this one. It is only half of this one. What the magnetic field? It's half. Right? So let me write. Clear? Next, right. Another point is that the magnetic field at a point just the end face of the solenoid. Magnetic field at a point just the end face of the solenoid, just the end face of the solenoid is B is equal to, for this Ni, half of this one, by mu. Mu naught Ni by 2. Clear? This is the case. And if you show that the variation of the magnetic field, the variation of the magnetic field in case of a solenoid, if you plot a graph, if a graph is plotted, the variation of the magnetic field, the variation of magnetic field of a solenoid, the variation of magnetic field of a solenoid with distance from the center, with the distance from the center. This is a solenoid, this is a center point. If you consider the magnetic field, the variation of magnetic field of a solenoid with the distance from the center is shown as, by a graph you can show that. That is the x. From that axis you take from this, then you will show that this is the magnetic field, suppose B. Then where at the axis, so this is a solenoid, this is the axis, suppose center, so it is a maximum. It is maximum. And inside the solenoid, inside the, this is the axis, all the, everywhere the magnetic field is uniform, so this is strain uniform with the distance. Clear? Then after that it decreases like this. It decreases. This is inside, this is the portion, right, of the outside the axis, so it goes to zero. From the axis it goes to zero. Clear? And you can show that if this the length is L, you can show this is 0 point, this portion you can show this as a minus L by 2 axis, this portion is by symmetry you can say this side is minus L by 2, here it is plus L by 2, so this is a minus L by 2 and in this portion this is a plus L by 2, this is the minus L by 2 and this is a plus L by 2. The variation of magnetic field. So inside it is uniform. Then when you go outside, that is non uniform, very weak, it goes to zero, and this is the portion of minus L by 2 and this plus by L by 2. So this is about a law question, state FDS of Peter law, and derive an expression for the magnetic field due to a solenoid. And outside the solenoid, the magnetic field is a zero. Okay. Now we will go to the third applications of the Ampere's orbital law. So what is the third one? Now we have derived for solenoid, now we go for the toroid. The magnetic field due to a current carrying toroid. So to do it very fast, I have written this thing that I have already shown the figure of a toroid. This is a toroid. Think that what is a toroid, that this is the solenoid. If you join the two ends of the solenoid, this is one end, this is another end, this is a coil, tightly wound coil. If you join that, that is a toroid. So means a toroid is a ring shape. A toroid can be considered as a ring shaped closed solenoid. If this is the solenoid, these are the two ends of the solenoid, the wounded are, and if you join that, that is a circular ring. That ring shape is the toroid. So a toroid is a hollow circular ring. This region is hollow of finite thickness. There is a finite thickness on which a large number of tons of an insulated wire, insulated wires are closely wounded. Insulated wires means the wires are insulated so that if you join this, they are closed, means the current cannot flow like from wire to wire. They can go in the wire like in the tongs, not from sideway. That is the insulated wires. So this is the toroid. And the current enters and it goes in each tong like this, flows like this and come out. That is a toroid. So this is the toroid. What do you mean by a toroid? So do first that, already you have denied for the two cases, now we go to direct the case of the next. Another thing is that when you think about the toroid, as you know, this is a hollow, there is nothing. So inside the toroid also you can say, inside the hollow portion and outside the toroid, the magnetic field is considered as a zero. Right? The inside and outside the toroid, inside the hollow region and outside
outside the toroid, the magnetic field is zero. No magnetic field. Practically, there is no magnetic field inside this portion and this portion. And here I have got that. So this is the toroid. I have got the cross section like that. Then you have to be sure. So what it shows that? These are the terms from which the wire is coming out. We will show this is the wire portion and another wire. They are torn like that. So inside this portion, inside the thickness, inside this region, the magnetic field lines are concentric rings or concentric circular rings. In this portion, the magnetic field is inside the toroid is concentric rings. And one of the ring I have considered, one of the magnetic field whose radius is R, and this is a magnetic field line or this is a magnetic field inside the toroid. And we will calculate the magnetic field only inside, because this portion the magnetic field is zero, this portion magnetic field is zero, outside this is magnetic field is zero. Only this portion there is a magnetic field. Okay, so let me write here also. Consider a toroid of n number of terms for n number of terms for unit length. For unit length, and that n is equal to n by n, where n is the number of terms in the length n of toroid, where n is the number of terms in the length l of the toroid. Clear? Now, next we can write that the magnetic field lines inside the magnetic field lines inside the toroid, means that in that portion inside the toroid, the magnetic field lines inside the toroid is in the form of concentric circles. Consider such a circle of radius R. Consider such a circle of radius R. Then the direction of magnetic field and dl, which is the, this is a circle, the magnetic field always tangential to the circle, and dl also tangential, both are in the same direction. That already you know that. Clear? Then, now we will move first to the Ampere's circuital law. Clear? Is that clear? N is the number of terms for unit length. Then what is the length of this portion? 2 pi r. L is equal to 2 pi r, that we will use. Okay? Now, come to this portion is that, according to Ampere's circuital law, B dot dl over this ring is equal to mu naught into, let me write, net current enclosed by the ring of radius R. Net current enclosed by the of the circle, net current enclosed by the ring or of radius R. Next, what is the angle between these two? Zero. So I can write B dl cos zero. Right? B dl cos zero is equal to mu naught. What is the net current enclosed by the radius this in this portion? What is the net current? If n is the number of terms per unit length, then what is the total length? N into 2 pi r.
And what is the current length? I. So that is equal to N into 2 pi R into I, or you simply write this as N is equal to number of turns per unit length, here N by 2 pi R. So N is equal to N into 2 pi R. This formula is for your understanding. Right? So the number of turns on this length is suppose capital N, which is radius is length is 2 pi R circumference, N into 2 pi R into I. Right? Then mu naught N into 2 pi R I. Then this will be B is uniform, so you can take outside uniform. In this portion also that magnetic field is uniform. So B is outside constant. Integration of cos 0 is 1, so this is integration of dl over this path, 2 pi r path is equal to mu naught n 2 pi r I. B L mu naught n 2 pi r I. What is the length of this portion? 2 pi r. So B into 2 pi r is equal to mu naught n 2 pi r I. 2 pi r, 2 pi r get cancelled. B is equal to mu naught n I. What is in your solenoid case? Where n is the number of turns per unit length. Okay. So you can write this is also in terms of capital N also. B is equal to, you can write mu naught n is what? Here n is equal to small n is equal to what? N into 2 pi r. So that is equal to small n. So that I can write. Sorry, I have made this confusion. N capital N, number of terms for unit length. So this is equal to N by 2 pi r. So N is equal to N into 2 pi r. Right? So I can write N is equal to, small n is equal to number of, total number of turns per unit length. N into 2 pi r into I. Remember this. N is equal to N by L, number of turns per unit length. So we will make like this. If any core is there, permeability is mu, then B is equal to mu n I, mu n by 2 pi r into I. Accordingly, you can do this. So this is the case of a torrent. Okay. And what is the magnetic field inside the hollow portion, outside? It is a zero, already you have written. So this is the case of a torrent. This may be a short question, 3-mark question. Clear? So this is about the different applications of Ampere's circuit law. Thank you.